I think there was someone at the back.
First of all, I want to thank you very much, Mr. Khan, for your time. Then, as you know, this time, the world is facing the financial crisis. You know, stock exchange and money exchange. What I am afraid of is the economical crisis.
Yes.
Now, the most important thing is the real estate for every country. You said that UN is we the people, not we the governments. What I want to ask about is the role for the UN in developing the ability for civil society in enhancing small projects. I think that small projects is the real assets for every country. Now, what's the UN role in developing this field, and how can we benefit from the UN experience in this field? Thank you.
I think it's an excellent question. I fully agree with your assessment that the economic crisis will follow. And I think now is the opportunity. When there is a crisis, sometimes we need to think about it as a crisis that we should not waste, because there is always an opportunity in a crisis situation to change and to achieve results which one would not normally be able to achieve. There is strong understanding at the United Nations that what you are saying is for people to come and together or with civil society participation to be able to generate projects which they can implement, they can carry out, and therefore they can benefit from directly and raise their income levels and improve their economic well-being. And this approach is now very widely recognized in the United Nations system. As you know, there is a whole movement of microfinance. There is a whole movement of providing banking and credit facilities for small and medium enterprises. There is an institute, International Trade Center in Geneva, which is designed primarily to help small and medium enterprises to advance in the developing world through training, through exchange of best practice, through creating networks of such enterprises who can then benefit and learn from each other. And in every economic report that you see in the United Nations, of course, one of the things that United Nations, the ways it helps developing countries in the development process, is also accumulating knowledge and doing analysis and doing assessments and providing the best possible information, experience to the countries and to the people. And the major reports, the economic and financial reports, you will always see a section which deals with this issue of microfinance, access to credit, and how to support small enterprises and medium enterprises, and how to help women and poor people in rural areas in community organizations to achieve their economic goals through small enterprises. One example I can give you is this, you must have heard of the telephone lady in Bangladesh, where the UN, working together with the Grameen Foundation of Microfinance, they launched a project which is now one of the most successful project for poor women anywhere in the world. 13 million women are participating in a project where a mobile telephone becomes a source of income for the community through small enterprise. And that is now growing rapidly in other countries. In my country, in Pakistan, there are 3 million women who are participating in a similar project. And this is being replicated. Of course, the model and the business environment are different, so the models have to adapt to local conditions. But how to get this experience out, we are trying to do in the Global Alliance by building platforms for exchanging best practice, so that you can go and check and see what is happening on microfinance, for example, or what is happening in banking for small enterprises, things like that. And of course, technical assistance is also there. UNDP and other UN organizations such as UNCTAD, they provide technical assistance in terms of know-how, in terms of accounting, in terms of financial structure, in terms of business models, and in terms of training for small employees, small enterprises employees to be trained in a way that they can continue to grow. So there are all types of mechanisms which are available. I think there's someone at the back.
No, we have a lady now.
No?
Excellent, we have a lady now.
I wanted to ask you, Kaza, on the UN's agenda at the moment.
Close.
Rebuilding Gaza.
Oh, very much so. Very much so. There has been a major effort on the part of the of UNRWA and of the World Bank and UNDP and many other organizations. The Secretary General set up a task force on the subject, and every effort is being made, first of all, to alleviate the condition of the people who have suffered so hard, so much, and also for reconstruction and development. Yes.
Thank you very much. I want to express our appreciation by giving you a token shield, our shield of gratitude for your kind participation at the forum and for helping with this. So, thank you.
Thank you very much.
We need to help with the technology.
Thank you very
thank
much.
You. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Thank you very much. Thank you all for your participation. And I'm delighted and grateful to have had you join us this afternoon. Your Excellency, thank you very much.